Welcome back to Final Fantasy Type-0. We're still in the middle of this mission, and I'm supposed to go to the Dominion's temporary HQ, wherever that is, so I'll just follow the yellow arrows on the mini-map, I guess. Jack is getting it done. I'm down to just a few party members. What the fuck?
Come forth.
That's fucking amazing. And that everything. Yep. Well, at least they were nice enough to give me a save point before that. Okay, well,
I'm sorry.
This is borderline impossible.
Go on. Dodge this.
You don't have to tell me.
I guess this is doing nothing to the rider. I guess all of this is doing absolutely nothing to the fucking rider. Because that makes a lot of fucking sense. There we go.
Thank you.
I guess I'm buff. Yeah, I might have to do that game. I don't have any long range attacker, so I'm kind of fucked while trying to shoot down the rider.
Will not escape! Come forth!
You don't have to tell me.
I can't go.
There! Go! It's do or die!
Forget about me.
Oh shit, yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to turn down the difficulty here. Fuck it.
Goodbye!
And now all of a sudden it's not letting me. Can I just abandon the mission? Yeah. Fuck. Gonna have to do it though. It'll be interesting to see how much easier or not this is with the difficulty change. I could not keep playing in that difficulty I was in because I was just 200 level and I was getting one-shotted.
I'm rooting for you!
We're counting on you.
Good luck to you!
I think I want to go about this differently now.
Thank you.
gotta redo this whole mission. Oh well. Oh well.
Goodbye. Incoming enemy unit confirmed. Prepare the autocannon.
Come what may, we'll handle them just the same.
Targets at 5 o'clock. Don't let even.
Hopefully, I don't die as Ace on this thing like I did last time. I do kind of like this. I mean, it's pretty basic. Not much to it, but it's a fun little change of pace.
It's coming aboard!
All combatants, get that dragon off this ship!
The boat, here goes!
Combat on top of the frozen clouds.
We've encountered Concordian troops! Be careful! They're using monsters!
Goodbye.
Oh, right. The Concordians can control monsters.
Then we just have to take them down!
Yeah, this has not turned into child's play. So, I mean, that's a good thing. Oh, shit. Yeah, changing the difficulty has not made it child's play now. Fuck off. Fuck off, dude. Please somebody heal me. Please somebody heal me. Please somebody heal me. Please somebody fucking heal me. Thank you. Fucking annoying ass fucking Bland. Gotta be fucking kidding me, dude.
All right, I'm here.
Just fucking grind. Even though I don't want to do that. Maybe I should just fucking do it. Now we can get through this. Might have to do it though in the future because these missions seem to just be getting harder and harder.
Send out the beasts! Inform the dragons!
Try some of this! Class 4 currently engaging the enemy! We're unable to find our
way! I don't know, I might just have to fucking grind it over a while.
A battle has broken out on the frozen cloud. All units rally together.
So I don't think I can take this final boss, even with the difficulty lowered. Oh my god.
Goodbye.
Now the game. What? Might have gotten myself into a corner here.
Good luck.
Well, on the bright side here, that lets me do it right now. Okay, on the bright side, the game looks still got to do this right now. Yeah, hell yeah. I'm glad this game gives me this to grind. If only these guys gave me like a shit ton of experience.
Hey.
think I'm gonna try and get everybody to level 25. So we're gonna be here a while. This is what we're doing for a while now. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. That kind of sucks.
I wish this would give you like double, maybe even triple experience.
And this would just be like a way to just give you a shit ton of experience. So I'm not sure like what the game exactly expects you to do. I mean, I guess the game just really wants you to try to explore the world, explore the dungeons in the world, and I don't know. Like, that's what you're supposed to do in between missions, and yeah, all this time to use in between missions. It just feels like it's a wild goose chase for Cindy on. To, like, travel through the world map, get thrown into random encounter after random encounter, I just can't run from. There's no, like, I really don't know exactly where to go or what exactly to do. I mean, this just seems like a better way to try and grind and get experience, because it's just constant battles against enemies that are the same level as me. So I don't really see how any other way would be a faster way to get experience. I wish they would tell me like how much experience I'm getting from each enemy I defeat here. Games always making me have to look some shit up. I swear. But yeah, I might just have to look up like best way to grind characters in this game. Because I hope there's a better way than this. Honestly, I wish Cadet did make the difficulty a joke. Maybe I shouldn't have given up as fast as I did. I just got to those bomb enemies and early on, and it proved to be still very difficult. And I maybe still got through the mission, but I just figured that wyvern boss would have still wiped the floor with my party members.
Your staff.
fucking level up. But... I mean, the next Ace has gained 77,000 experience to be level 21. The next level up, he has to gain another 12,000. That's like, less than one seventh of the experience he has now. That just seems a little steep to me. Yeah, closer to 1/6 than 1/7. Yeah, the difficulty is still cadet, and really these battles, they do seem a bit easier. So I can change the difficulty back. Officer. We get with the difficulty up some.
Fire until you have ammo! Stop!
Much more difficult. It really does not. It is not noticeable. Sorry, I had to step away for a bit. Let's just fucking try this out. Why the fuck not? Just try it out real quick, see what happens. Yeah. Yeah. That's crazy though. It's even like. Damn. Like. It's fucking tough enough playing the game in these regular difficulties when you're underleveled. Like, how can you play the game? That's crazy. People that can actually do that can beat the game in the hardest difficulty. I don't know how they do it. Honestly, I think it might be best just to try and play this game really only using like 5 more or less characters and just focusing on leveling them up instead of all 14. Also, because you're just spreading out the grinding with each character, and no character is really getting tough now. They're all behind, which is gonna make it tough to get through missions. I think you'd just be better off just picking 5, let them get all the level ups. And hopefully you can just make short work of enemies with them. Situation like I'm in now though, in this next mission where Machina's gone, and the party members kind of get split up into 2 groups, You know, stuff like that might present a challenge. Besides that, like, the whole game has basically just been, like, I've had all 14 members together at once for every mission. Like, it's never been a situation where, like, the game's forcing me to use three certain characters, like Trey and Rem and Seven. Like, I have to use those three in this particular mission. Something like that would very, very easily fuck you, potentially. If I had to pick five members, though, it seems like to me the members that I've liked using the most have been Ace, Deuce, honestly, maybe Queen, 8, King, Jack. So maybe take out Queen and have Ace, Deuce, King, Jack, and 8. Yeah. You wouldn't think Deuce would be that good. But I don't know. It seems like when I've used her for the most part, she's been very effective. I think this is going to be a shorter video here. I'm going to try this out. But yeah, I think I'm just inevitably going to have to just try and look up something to see if I can find a way better way to grind my characters than this. I might just have to redo fucking missions. I don't know. I mean, it's... I don't know if there exists a good way to do this. I might just have to focus on just doing what I just said to do and just focus, like, leveling up 5 characters and just say hell to the rest of them. For now, let's give this a try, because I've not done this yet, and this is something I probably should have done a long time ago. Okay, well, I'm at a point now where I'm going to stop playing for a while, so I'm just going to leave the game running on the title screen. I don't know if I put the PS4 in rest mode, if that'll mess it up or not, but yeah, this is something I definitely can't do often. This is not really a good way to level up characters, and I don't even know how well it's going to work. I come back to the game and Ace is like level 30. Then I guess it's pretty useful, all in all, but still, I can't do that very fucking character, just like, stop playing the game for an hour, 14 times, get all characters to level 30. I don't know, I'm gonna have to end up looking something up here, and I don't know if there really is gonna be a good way to level up these characters, and I don't know, I want to beat this game, I do. I don't want to just give up on it. I am tempted to just give up on this game if I have to fucking spend hours and hours grinding. And I probably won't. I'll just fucking grind up 5 characters and hope for the best with them. I don't think I'm gonna fucking grind all 14 characters here. That's just too much. And it's just shit like this that's really fucking holding this game back. Annoying shit like this. You know, arguably, you could say this game has more shit going against it than Final Fantasy 13 did. Because 13... Me, personally, I feel like 13 could have been a great game. It really wasn't necessarily missing anything to make it a great game. Kind of. I mean, the battle system could have been different and better. But, like, the biggest thing that held 13 back was just how just unnecessarily difficult and annoying fights got. And there were other things that held it back, too. And there are some things I wish they could have done differently in that game, don't get me wrong. I just feel like this game is not as fleshed out as 13 was, because I feel like all in all, 13 was fleshed out. It was deep enough in story and in gameplay and gameplay mechanics. I feel like this game just isn't, for the most part. But this game is just as annoying. This game's difficulty doesn't scale good at all. It gets too difficult, but the game does that intentionally because they want you to fucking go out and do all this optional shit to keep up with the difficulty of the game. But I feel like the game just wants you to go. I'm not sure exactly what the game wants you to do besides, like, go out and try and find these dungeons that you can find. I feel like there's probably not even that many of them. And I feel like the game is just asking you to do too much and to try and go out and keep up with the game's difficulty. It's just too much of a wild goose chase. It's really not clear what you have to do. To go around and explore the world map, you're going to constantly get thrown into random encounter after random encounter on the world map, and there's nothing you can do to run away from battles. I mean, the battles aren't difficult at all. They take like 15 seconds to 20 seconds to get through, but it's still just a constant. It's just constantly slowing down the pace of the game. So it's just one of those games. The longer I'm playing it, the more I'm seeing the issues. It's really like Final Fantasy 13, honestly, in that regard. Like, I was high on 13 in the beginning. Then it just, as I kept playing the game, the more and more it kept crashing down, and this game is similar. I mean, I was definitely higher on Final Fantasy 13 in the beginning than I was on this game. But yeah, I'm really starting to see the glaring issues of this game now. And I guess the pain might just be beginning. But anyway, that's going to do it for this one. And until next time.